وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. In light of the first ayah, just a simple, quick reminder. The first ayah Sheikh Abdulaziz recited was وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Very well known ayah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us, well, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala وَذَكَّ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind, because reminder verily indeed does benefit the believer. As Allah to let all of us to be believers. What Allah says in this ayah, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. Your Lord has ordained, has commanded that you shall worship none but Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately, قال وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Look to the order now. Allah is declaring, is tolling, letting us aware that He has decided, He has commanded, He has ordained, which means you just know and apply. It's not a matter for discussion. Al-Qadha. Please just know it, and that's it. And it's Allah. It's not a judge or a person or a king. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا لَهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ. Here comes, then immediately, and be gentle, respectful, obedient to your parents. Because the word ihsan, it's a very general, rich, holistic terminology in Arabic language. You can't translate it with one word. Because the word ihsan includes gentleness. It includes being kind. It includes respect. It includes obedience. All of them, they are part of ihsan. It's an amazing word. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And maybe the Arabs will be more able to understand what I will be saying now. You know the letter ba, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ. The ba, you know, this is called the preposition. When you say بِالْوَالِدَيْنِ, the meaning of الْبَا is الْإِلْصَاق. It contains the meaning of when you stick something to something else. Okay? So it's a preposition. When Allah says بِالْوَالِدَيْنِ, it indicates that your ihsan should be accompanying your parents as if it's something stuck to them, which means 24/7. It's not a duty that is done sometimes. It's not something that, okay, from time to time when I'm not busy, I will do ihsan. No, it's as if it tells you you have to be muhsin with your parents 24/7. The message, number one in terms of importance in Islam is to worship Allah. Number two, immediately, is being muhsin with your parents. This is a message, actually we know it, but it's just a reminder in case some of us, for whatever reason, he lost the compass or his GPS might be losing the right order of priorities in this life. And this should help us, inshallah, how to rearrange our priorities in our life when we want to do anything in our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us be from those who worship Allah truly and from those who do the ihsan to their parents. And by the way, let me finish with this. Even if your parents are dead or one of them, you know, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمَ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا. If the son of Adam passed away, his connection in terms of gaining the ajr will be disconnected unless from three main channels. One of them, waladun salihun, yad'u lah. Righteous, good walad. By the way, walad in Arabic, it's applicable on dhakar and untha. It's not just for a boy. Walad does not mean boy in Arabic language. Okay? Walad is up. It's used for male and female, which means a daughter or a son which is righteous and good and he's making dua or doing any good deed. So you can make dua, you can keep doing all good deeds and the ajr, bi-idhnillah, will reach to them even after of death, with the direct hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
جزاك الله خير ابو عمر،
ربي
يبارك معنا احنا دائما
حبيبي.